everyone. Welcome back to Strange Mind 6. I'm your host, Ruby, and today we're going to be getting back into Creepers, Pen Pals by Edgar J. Hyde. If you haven't already, please go grab a snack or a drink or sit back and relax, and let's get to it. Chapter 6, Let's Dance. Olivia was excited about the Halloween dance tonight and felt as though her geography lesson would never end. She and Natasha both had their costumes ready and couldn't wait to get home and dress up. I wonder what Marcy and Elise are doing. Maybe they told Natasha and she forgot to say, or maybe it's a big secret, Olivia mused. Both she and Natasha had made a pact to forget all about Susanna Craigson for this one night and simply go to the Halloween dance and have fun. The bell began to ring, and the students threw books and anything else they had in their bags. Olivia caught up with Natasha outside the class. Thought that was never gonna end, she smiled at her friend. Natasha smiled back. Hey, Elise, she called. Olivia looked in the direction Natasha was facing and saw Elise's retreating back as she left the school building. Her dark curls bobbed as she flounced out of the door, but she didn't seem to hear her friends as she kept walking. Strange, said Natasha. I could have sworn she saw us, and I'm almost positive she's not far enough away that she wouldn't have heard me yell. She looked confused for a second or two. Oh well, let's get out of here. We have a lot to do before we meet up tonight, and then we'll discover the secrets behind Marcy's and Elise's costumes. The gymnasium was brightly lit, but just by lights, but not just by lights, but by strategically placed pumpkins with the insides removed to make room for short, dim candles. One by one, the students arrived, gushing over each other's costumes and guessing the identity of those who wore masks. Loud music filled the gym, from the speakers set up on the stage, and banners suspended from the ceiling had words, "Welcome to the annual Halloween dance," written on them. Natasha was just arriving and was trying to adjust her wig as she got out of her mother's car. For heaven's sake, Natasha, leave it alone or you'll end up with no wig at all, her mother sighed. Bye, Cleo. Tommy smiled from the back seat, his fingers opening and closing over his chubby little hand as he waved goodbye. He couldn't quite say Cleopatra, so Natasha had said Cleo would suffice. Goodbye, Tommy. She blew a kiss as she stepped out onto the street. Now, Natasha, her mother began. I know, Mom, she interrupted. I won't be late. Mrs. Morris smiled as she put the car into drive and drove away from the curb. Have a nice time, Natasha. Goodbye. Natasha waved at Tommy as he waved out of the back window. Then, with one last pull at her wig, she joined the other students as they entered the gym. Over here, Natasha, she heard Olivia call. She turned to see her friend, Fox cigarette holder in silken gloved hand, wearing her beaded sequins dress and topped with a small hat on her head with a very large feather. "Olivia, you look terrific," she laughed as she joined her friend. "So do you, Nat. Your makeup is fantastic. You look like a dead person reincarnated. Your eyes are so black." The two girls laughed together and went in search of the rest of their classmates. There was a prize for the best costume, and most of the students worked hard to be in the running. A passing gorilla growled at Olivia. Olivia laughed. "Unfortunately, I'll never know who he is. There are at least 6 different gorillas here." The girls made their way toward the end of the gym, where soft drinks were being served. "Hey, look, there's Batman over there." Natasha smiled, "and Catwoman's with him. Just look at the length of her claws, and I thought my nails were long." A rather silly-looking cat stood beside the soft drinks table, smiling now and again at a sequined Elvis. "Isn't this so much fun?" Natasha nudged Olivia. "Olivia, what on earth's wrong with you?" Olivia looked like she was in some sort of trance, but the look of fear was on her face. It told Natasha there was something very wrong. She followed Olivia's gaze to the far side of the gym to the spot they had just left, and immediately saw what had caught her friend's attention. A slight, fair-haired girl had just entered the room. She wore a long cream-colored gown that was very old-fashioned and had frills around the cuffs and hem. On the back of her head, she wore a small matching bonnet. "Oh my God," Natasha breathed. "It can't be, can it?" The two girls were frozen. Then Natasha felt a tug on her arm. "Hi, girls." Natasha turned around. "It's me, Marcy." Marcy was dressed in a pale blue dress with a short white apron tied around it. In her hair, she wore a large headband, and under her arm, she had tucked a white rabbit. Natasha tried to regain her composure. She had hoped that the girl they had been looking at in the distance was in fact Marcy. But if the girl standing beside her was Marcy, dressed as Alice in Wonderland, then that ruled out that possibility. "Hi, Marcy," Natasha said. "Olivia?" She pulled on her friend's arm. "Look, isn't Marcy a perfect Alice?" Olivia turned. "Oh, yes, yes," stumbled Olivia. "Your costume's great." She tried to show some enthusiasm, but kept feeling her eyes being dragged back to the slight figure at the other end of the room. "Told you, family tradition," Marcy continued. "Apparently, my great-great-great-aunt actually, I'm not sure how many greats it is, knew Lewis Carroll. You know, the person who wrote Alice in Wonderland and Through the Looking Glass, and based Alice's sister on her. I mean, I know she only played a small part, the sister that is, but our family became very Alice obsessed after that. Every Halloween, we use it as an opportunity to indulge a little in the book's character. I've gone as a white rabbit before, but that can get very hot and stuffy." Marcy's voice droned on and on in the background, and by the time Natasha wasn't paying attention, Marcy, I hate to be rude, but there's someone we have to talk to over there. We'll be back in a few minutes. Excuse us. The two girls moved away and hurried to the far end of the room. Marcy turned away, feeling slightly annoyed, and limped toward the drinks table. As Natasha and Olivia approached the fair-haired girl, turned towards them with a smile on her lips. "Hello, Natasha, Olivia," she murmured. "What do you think?" Natasha and Olivia stopped in their tracks. Olivia looked quizzically at the girl. "Elise?" she questioned. "Darn," said Elise. "I knew you'd guess it was me. It's the dark eyebrows, isn't it?" Natasha and Olivia started to breathe again. Natasha's eyes traveled to Elise's feet, but she wore normal shoes, not a built-up one like the real Susanna. "But who are you supposed to be?" the girls asked. "Well, I know I'm not anyone famous," she said, "but my mom found a trunk in the attic, and this was one of the outfits inside. It fit perfectly. I haven't had time to make anything because of all the time I've been spending with Scott and everything, so I decided I'd just come as a girl from the 1800s. You two look very glamorous, though. Maybe I made the wrong choice," finished Elise. "No, you look really great," Natasha managed. "We left Marcy by the drinks table, so we should probably go back and get her. Are you coming?" "Yes, in a minute or two. I just want to find Scott. He said he was dressing as a gorilla." "You haven't seen him, have you?" Olivia and Natasha joined Marcy. "Marcy, I'm really sorry," said Olivia. "Let me look at your costume again." Marcy smiled. "Well, I have to admit, I was a bit hurt earlier, but I'll forgive you." She twirled, showing a full flounces of the skirt with the stiff net petticoat underneath. "Don't know how they ever wore these things, though," she said. "Give me a pair of sweatpants any day." The girls laughed. Natasha and Olivia smiled at one another. "Come on," said Olivia, as they went onto the dance floor. "Let's have some fun." Just as the girls were growing tired from all the fun, the evening was coming to an end. The pumpkins had lost their glow, as most of the guests had as well. Parents were soon lining up in their cars outside, waiting to pick up their children. The four friends stood on top on the top step outside the school. "Oh, I almost forgot," said Elise. "My mom said I could invite you all over tomorrow since it's Saturday. Please say you'll come. She and my dad are going out for the day, and we'll have the house to ourselves. Come on, you've never been to my house before. Say you'll come." The girls were thrilled to be invited. Elise was right. They hadn't been to her house before. "We'll be there," they returned. "Great," Elise said with a smile. "Come over at 12 o'clock. You too, Alice." She nudged Marcy. "And bring your white rabbit if you like." Then Elise ran off down the steps. "Wait, Elise, don't you want a ride?" shouted Olivia. But Elise was gone, ringlets streaming behind her as she ran off into the darkness. "Oh well, seems like she didn't want a ride," Olivia said as her father's car pulled up to the curb. The three girls clambered in, stifling yawns as they pulled on their seatbelts and yanked at annoying wigs and stiff petticoats and frowned at sequinless patches on their dresses. "No one turned into a pumpkin," joked Mr. Golden. "No, Dad," returned Olivia. "Nor did any of us meet our handsome princes." Natasha leaned her head back against her seat and closed her eyes for the short car journey home. And that is the end of Chapter 6. Tune in next video to hear Chapter 7, Gate Fells. This has been Ruby, signing off.